My annual pilgrimage during the summer vacations from this year was the chosen destination of Chamba in Himachal Pradesh. Chamba is about 580 kilometers from Delhi, and therefore the journey to Chamba would take 14 long hours, and it would be a very tiresome journey. Therefore, I decided to board the train from Delhi up till Pathankot is the nearest railhead from Chamba, about 118 kilometers. It is a small, nondescript little place situated in the junction of Jammu Kashmir, Punjab and Himachal. From Pathankot, one makes the way towards Himachal Pradesh through many small destinations, and just after leaving Pathankot, the road slowly starts winding up towards Himachal across small hillocks. But this stretch of the road is rather irksome because the smaller hills means larger number of roundabouts and difficult driving situations. Although the road is good, yet for the persons who are suffering from travel sickness, it is indeed a difficult proposition. However, the road itself is quite picturesque and one enjoys the journey, and as you gradually climb up towards the hills, you come to notice the change in the vegetation, which slowly turns greener, and a little ahead you can see the huge Ranjit Sagar dam with copious amounts of water stored in it. The road gradually climbs up and thereafter it descends below to the valley and to a nondescript little village called Nainikhat. It is a marketplace for the nearby villages situated atop the hills, and we stopped here for a generous hospitality from the Mahajan family, who runs a small clothes shop here. Having crossed Nainikhat, the road starts ascending upwards and you move up to Banikhet. Banikhet is a rather commercial place, buzzing with activity of all kinds, and there are shops galore and also many small hotels. The reason for this commercial explosion in this nondescript little village is because it is a main junction point where from the road bifurcates towards Chamba to one side and towards Dalhousie, the famed hill station of Chamba district of Himachal Pradesh, on the other side. During the peak summer months, the rush of the individuals in this area is so huge that it is difficult for the people at times to get accommodation in Dalhousie, and they come down till Banikhet to rest for the night. Having gone a few kilometers ahead of Banikhet, we came across the beautiful Chamera Dam, and thereafter the River Ravi accompanies you all along with its beautiful blue waters rippling across the mountain side as you slowly head towards Chamba. And the entire river has been dammed at many places, and hydroelectric power projects like Chamera 1, 2, 3, 4 have come up. Chamba itself is the oldest township of Himachal Pradesh, and its history can be traced back up to 6th century AD. It is the oldest township of Himachal Pradesh, and with the local dynasty of kings running till date, although their kingship is no longer there. Chamba is a mix of modernity and tradition. and can aptly be called the temple town of Himachal Pradesh, as there are ample number of temples dating back up to 10th century AD and beyond, and also many other such temples of ancient origin around. Having gone past Chamba, you head towards Bhrmore, which was the destination for the day, and Bhrmore is situated another 65 kilometers ahead of Chamba, and the total distance between Pathankot and Bhrmore is around 185 kilometers, and this roughly takes around 6 hours of drive in case you hire your own cab. This distance is covered by buses in almost 10 hours or more, as they stop at many destinations. A tourist can visit these destinations by bus because there are a large number of private buses also running. Right on the road, you will find many hydroelectric power stations which release copious amounts of water into the Ravi River, and these scenes are spectacular as they are to be seen to be believed. The place being untouched by the tourist rush reflects the pristine and beautiful and verdant views of the nature that the state of Himachal Pradesh has to offer. These places can be developed over the years into tourist destinations for visitors from foreign countries especially. Although Bhrmore during the Mani Mahesh pilgrimage that takes place during the monsoon season, especially during July and August, has ample opportunity for the locals to gain some income, but the other destinations nearby Bhrmore, like Holi, are more spectacular and enriched with natural beauty which can be exploited by the Himachal government to gain not only money for the locals but also exposure for them. The roads, although were being repaired in the right earnest, but there are stretches in between which are really bad. The Bhrmore is also known as the land of the Gaddis. The Gaddis are the tribesmen who herd cattle for a livelihood and travel across the mountain passes during the summers right up to Leh Ladakh for the cattle and the flock of sheep and goat to graze on the mineral-rich meadows that are found high above in the mountain passes, so that the wool etc. that is being sold by them is of the highest class. The road runs through many rough terrains including tunnels which have specially been constructed by the hydroelectric power plants to divert the water up to higher reaches from these waters are released in a phased manner through pipes and turbines so as to generate hydroelectricity. The children enjoyed this stretch of tunnel as it was quite dark inside and only a distant ray of light, that is the opening of the tunnel at the other end, looked bright. Yet this journey from Chamba right up to Bhrmore is a pleasure trip for anyone who enjoys his journey in the Himalayan mountains. The road runs up till Khadamukh, a place which is in a deep valley, where from it bifurcates towards Holi and Bhrmore. One side of the road leads towards Bhrmore and the other going straight towards Holi. We turn left towards Bhrmore, as this was the destination for the day. The bridge itself is at a gorgeous natural spot, as the Budhil River coming in from the Bhrmore side meets the Ravi River at this point where the bridge has been constructed. You can spend a few minutes to check out the natural beauty, take a few shots with your camera, have some cold drinks and snacks in the small shops that are placed around the Khadamukh pass or bridge. The road further ahead towards Bhrmore becomes more narrower and treacherous. One has to drive very carefully across these roads, and the more slowly and carefully you drive, the more you enjoy the beauty of the nature, as you can see with your own eyes unfolding before you small nondescript villages placed precariously along the mountain sides and having a very difficult life in these places, which are usually covered in snow and blocked during the winter months. Bhrmore is famed for the famous Mani Mahesh Yatra, as informed earlier, and this is the first glimpse of the famous Mani Mahesh Peak, which is also known as one of the Kailash peaks where Lord Shiva resides. You may enjoy the beauty, and I hope this video also helps you in visiting the place.